Look, I don't have to be drunk to eat an entire $5 pizza by myself, but it does help. Hey there, inebriated Epicureans. Jules here for D News. If you're an alcohol drinking adult, then there's a good chance you found yourself shoving greasy, unpalatable food into your mouth at 2:30 a.m. for reasons that don't seem too clear the next morning. It's more than an anecdotal tale. People tend to eat a lot more food when they're drunk. A review article of multiple studies on the effects of alcohol on appetite, published in the journal Current Opinion in Clinical Nutrition and Metabolic Care, found that, quote, moderate alcohol consumption leads to a short-term increase in food intake. Now, what's puzzling is that alcohol is really calorically dense. A gram of pure alcohol contains more calories than a gram of carbohydrates or protein, and almost as many as in a gram of fat. Of course, you wouldn't want to drink pure alcohol, but even a typical beer has two-thirds as many calories as a small order of McDonald's French fries. It doesn't make sense for your body to down multiple beers, multiple orders of liquid fries, and then literally want more fries. Well, as it turns out, it may have less to do with caloric content and more to do with your brain. In a study published in 2017 in Nature Communications, scientists found that mice ate considerably more after they were injected with alcohol for 3 days straight, what they called an alcohol weekend. Then they exposed slices of mouse brains to alcohol and found that certain neurons fired more often. These particular neurons released a peptide, a small chain of amino acids called AGRP. AGRP tells your brain that you're hungry. So alcohol makes you want to eat regardless of whether or not you're packed full of calories already. Basically, your brain is telling you, hey, I'm starving, even if you totally aren't. What's even crazier? You might not even feel full after satisfying those cravings. A 2001 study of 7 men and 7 women in the journal Clinical Endocrinology found that alcohol consumption lowered production of a hormone called leptin. Leptin is the reason you feel full and satisfied after a meal. Without it, you never quite hit that sweet, full feeling that you're going for. The study posited that alcohol could directly suppress this hormone. But that's just one part of a complicated equation. It turns out that when you're drunk, you also tend to eat food that you might not normally find appetizing. The reason for this is believed to involve your opiate system. See, one of the reasons alcohol reduces pain, makes you feel good, and is addictive is that it has a strong effect on your opiate system, which is directly involved in pain, reward, and addiction. In particular, alcohol increases the presence of endogenous opioids. Now, these opioids are believed to be related to how your brain processes food, and in particular, its texture, taste, and overall palatability. A study in the European Journal of Neuroscience found that in rats, these opioids increase the desire to eat more sugary foods. So, if you normally avoid something like street tacos, you may not be so averse when you're drunk. So, in the end, being drunk means that you feel hungrier, don't end up feeling full, and eat grosser food. And that's just one small part of the whole drunk experience. Alcohol has a complex relationship with the body, and many people certainly feel those effects the next day in the form of a hangover. Ironically, eating before you get drunk is a good way to avoid a hangover, so just try not to eat or drink too much. Your body will thank you. So now that you're hungover, what do you do? Well, you can find out some cures science has cooked up in this episode right here. And do you have any more questions about drinking? Well, I've got plenty of experience answering questions. Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more D News every day of the week.